President Biden says he wants to save the earth and save union jobs. The electric vehicle duty credit in his social spending package shows how those plans can occasionally clash. Is Tesla in trouble after Biden's bold statement in favor of EV-less GM? Keep watching today's video to find out. But before that, make sure you've pressed the red subscribe button along with that tiny bell icon to get updated every time we post new videos. Let's get started. The offer being negotiated by House and Senate Democrats gives consumers the full duty write-off only if they buy electric vehicles assembled by union workers using American-constructed batteries. Motor cars produced in non-union manufacturers would qualify for $4,500 less. Michigan Democrats Representative Dan Kildee and Senator Debbie Stabenow wrote the electric vehicle duty credit after collaborating with the United Auto Workers and General Motors Co. about the significance of including an explicitly pro-union element. In the case of plug-in hybrids, the gas tank cannot exceed 2.5 gallons. This is for cars placed in service before 2027. Now comes the $5,000 boost. EVs and consumers will be able to qualify for another $4,500 in the duty credit if an automaker makes the EV in the US with a union manpower. Another $500 comes into play for automakers using a US-made battery for a maximum of $12,500 available. At the moment, the only auto that would qualify for anywhere near the full proposed credit is the Chevrolet Bolt EV and Bolt EUV. This provision would especially exclude Tesla, and indeed the Ford Mustang Mach-E, since it's assembled in Mexico. The labor-friendly provision has touched off a fierce prompting battle by Tesla Inc., Toyota Motor Corp., and other non-union auto companies that say Mr. Biden is betraying the environment to help a political supporter, the United Auto Workers. Biden is an UAW puppet, Tesla chief executive Elon Musk wrote on Twitter, replying to a tweet about the EV duty credits. Tesla, the world's biggest electric automaker, didn't respond to a request for comment. Biden's bipartisan infrastructure bill includes specific references to bolstering the US's EV charging networks that has led to a group of automakers dramatically boosting their 2030 EV sales predictions, even though the bill hasn't been signed yet. President Biden visited a GM electric vehicle assembly factory on Wednesday in the Detroit area and toured the recently renovated plant with GM chief executive Mary Barra. He also compactly drove around a parking area in the GMC Hummer electric pickup truck, which is set to go on sale in the coming weeks at a base price of around $100,000. "We're going to make sure the jobs of the future end up here in Michigan and not halfway around the world," he said. The infrastructure bill President Biden signed into law this month includes $7.5 billion to expand the network of electric vehicle charging stations. Tesla is by far the largest EV maker in the United States today. Still, those who buy an EV from the automaker won't be eligible to claim the car on their taxes. That's because the current law for the credits phases them out after a particular automaker sells over qualifying vehicles. In Tesla's case, it sold its last qualifying vehicle back in 2019, leaving no fresh duty credits to take advantage of. The same goes for General Motors. A Chevy, GMC, Buick, or Cadillac EV is not eligible for the EV duty credit as of today. The automakers continue to lobby for new legislation to make credits available to them once again. Changes to the EV duty credits would again open the door to Tesla's eligibility and to GM's. The changes would also keep these credits open for 10 years, with eligibility for any EV in the first 5 years. During the last 5 years, the credits would only apply to US-made EVs. In other words, Tesla and Tesla buyers would profit greatly from the Build Back Better bill. So that's all for today's video. Let us know your views in the comments section below. And don't forget to like this video before leaving. Thanks for watching.